Well, I didn't see that one coming.
I'm through playing games, Sasha. Give me the antidote.
There's no antidote. Julia's gonna die and Michael's gonna learn there are penalties for betraying me.
Give me the antidote, Sasha. Give it to me now.
What'd you do with my assassin?
I wouldn't worry about him. I'd worry about yourself. If Julia dies, there's no place you're gonna be able to hide from me.
Taking this a little too personally, aren't you?
You have no idea.
Sure, because I can do this.
No, I want to help. Just talk to me about something else.
Anything?
Yeah.
How about our wedding?
Did I miss the proposal?
Well, I get down on one knee, but...
You don't give up, do you?
Never.
So that's it?
Yeah, excellent.
It's gonna be okay?
Yeah, that's all I can do for now.
Okay, what about stitches?
Oh, no. I have a little scar, nothing big. Probably kill my dream of being a leg model. I'm just kidding. Look, I'm a little tired. I just can rest here for a little second. You mind?
No, of course.
Hey, you're an excellent nurse.
Thank you.
Julia.
Jack, I...
Julia. I love you.
Jack.
Thank you.
You know, this is one big setup, right?
How's that, sir?
Well, why else would Rachel tell me to stop by for a haircut and then report me to the police? She wants to use this to screw me in the divorce.
Oh, I doubt that.
And ruin my career.
You know, I'm unfamiliar with your business, sir. Do two extremely small jobs a year make a career? I'll leave my curiosity about the part-time actor's life aside. Let's talk about last night.
What's to talk about? I got a part on a big feature film. She told me to come. She volunteered to cut my hair.
And while you were there, did you have an argument? Did she take a little too much off the top?
No, we didn't have an argument.
You know, it's hard to believe that he doesn't work more because you are just so convincing.
Look, I just got a part on a big studio film,
okay.
So
Wait. Let's start again. Let's start again, and this time I want you to remember that those hair and makeup trailers have very thin walls, and people hear things all the time.
Did you argue with your wife, sir?
We had a small disagreement.
What about?
Look, I have done everything that Rachel has asked me to do. I even apologized for every single argument that we ever had. And I took those anger management classes Donna recommended.
Who's Donna?
Her friend, Donna. I never met her. I don't even know her last name, but it still doesn't stop Donna from convincing my wife that I'm an asshole. Which I'm not. I mean, I'm passionate, okay? I'm sensitive. That's what all good actors are supposed to be. But I love my wife, which is why I have stayed away from her, just like she has.
But you didn't stay away from her, sir. You saw her last
night. Because she told me I could!
If I were you, sir, I'd put my ass back in that chair.
Well, I think it's safe to say that you are a freshman in anger management. So, I'm supposed to believe that after you gave your wife a concussion and broke her wrist, she called you up and said, hey, come on over for a haircut? A haircut you felt the need to lie about?
Here we go.
I didn't want to get any trouble, okay?
Is that how you usually avoid trouble? You just lie to the police?
Look, I made a mistake, okay?
A mistake? Oh, like violating your restraining order? Or lying to me about
I did not violate the spirit
night.
Of the order.
Tell me, how many mistakes
I
did it take before your wife ended up like this?
Oh, my God. Rachel. Is she dead?
Not just dead. Murdered. Savagely beaten. And to me, it looks like someone was very angry.
I want a lawyer.
Fine. Sergeant, will you please see that Mr. Hughes here gets his phone call?
Chief Johnson was wrong about one thing.
What?
This guy's a much better actor than we thought.
Call a cab? Thanks for getting my money back. Or what was left of it. Either way, it was the cheapest divorce I ever had.
You know, you can convince yourself all day long that you came down here chasing after that money. But we both know the truth, don't we?
Look, the truth is that Helen got what she deserved.
Really?
Okay. You know what? You can take off, bro.
Whoa, that's my cab. No, that was your cab.
Hey, what the hell is going on here? Get your hands off of me.
I'm placing you under arrest for felony assault. And in Nevada, that carries, what, 3 to 13?
I've never touched her in Nevada.
No, I'm not talking about your ex-wife. I'm talking about my medical examiner, Doc Robbins. The guy on crutches that you pushed.
Oh, come on, man.
Yeah, that's like hitting a cop.
Are you joking? The judge is gonna laugh you out of court.
Maybe he will, maybe he won't, but it's like 4 o'clock on a Friday afternoon. Nothing's gonna happen till Monday morning. Have a good weekend.
Hey!
Once the Vicks realized there was something wrong, they tried to escape.
Hey! Hey, man! Pull over!
Buddy, because you hit your dumb little unimportant star to one that shines so much brighter than yours. And do you know how much it hurts when that wondrous, magical star suddenly flickers out and dies in your life and you end up being just shut in the shadows? It hurts so much. You will not take away my star. You will not take away my Sean. I want you to open your mouth. I said open your mouth. Get some goddamn dignity.
When I climb up the stairs and by my bed he listens.
See the stuffing? It's going inside you now. That's it.
Just play.
No, I'm not okay. It's Emma.
Shh. Emma. Ben, you need to calm down. You're not making any sense. Just tell me what's wrong. What's got you spooked so bad?
I don't know what it is. I was in Amelia's room, and there was something I saw. I saw something. I saw, I don't know what I saw, but I saw something. And then the next minute, she was... And just now, right here with Emma, she was in there. And she was hurt. And then, she was dead.
I don't understand.
I'm trying to tell you that I think Emma is dead.
Who is Emma?
Oh, my God.
What are you doing here?
Well, Jackson and I are in the same soccer league.
Lynette, this is Bill Brown. We were roommates freshman year in college.
Really?
Yeah. God, you look fantastic. You haven't aged a day.
Hey, we're back at you.
Liar. You didn't even recognize me.
Back up a second. You guys were classmates?
Yeah.
Meaning you were in the same class at the same time?
That's what classmates means, Lynette. We're the same age.
Actually, I think I'm 6 months older.
But see, that's what I don't understand. I've been told that neither one of you have ever been in trouble at PCA before, so why now?
Well, we've always had serious behavioral issues. They've just been dormant.
Yeah.
But I still don't understand what...
Do you have a girlfriend? What are you, like 6'1"?
I don't... Well, I saw you, that's for sure. I mean, how could I not? A beautiful girl sitting here all by herself.
Well, rub it in.
I'm sorry?
Nothing.
Do you mind if I join you?
Well, that's why we're here, to begin that process. Look, you're a doctor. We want to help people. We care about our clients' entire lives, not just their careers. For example, this is a list of organizations with which we're involved.
Doctors Without Borders, NRDC, Habitat for Humanity.
This week, we're actually taking an afternoon off and building a house in New Orleans to help aid Katrina victims. Have you helped with the Katrina effort, Sean?
Look, you work this right, this could be worth a pound or maybe two.
I know everything about that car, inside out.
You get him on the hook. You tell him to follow you inside. Won't even turn around. All right? Go on. Go make me proud.
Sit up.
It's a deal breaker, Michael. But trust me, I could handle the security without it. Security is about risk assessment, smart decision making. If I do my job right, I won't have to use a gun.
All right, if you're sure.
I'm sure.
Jack. We're old friends, right?
That's right.
What happened to you in the military?
Respectfully, Michael. Talking about it means thinking about it. I don't want to do either. You think I was born yesterday? I know a lie when I hear one. Look, your father's involved in some very dangerous business.
Is he a criminal?
He loves you, Caroline.
Come on, Jack, I know he loves me.
Look, you did a very brave thing today. You stuck your neck out for me. And I'm very grateful. But you gotta promise me.
Jack!
Listen to me. You gotta promise me that you will never interfere with your father's business again. You got it?
Is it that bad?
I'm here to protect you. That's my job. That's what I'm doing. You understand?
Yeah.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Hey, Jack. Thank you.